Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a good-looking car.
Dude, that's nice.
So you got the deal done, huh?
Yeah.
What'd we end up paying for it?
18.
$1,800. I spotted this 52 coupe online the other day for sale by a little old lady up in Wichita Falls. I gave Mater some cash and sent him off to make her an offer. Dude, this car will sell for $5,000 like it is.
This car is clean. I mean, it's together. The whole car's here.
And then if we maybe buff it up a little bit, I think I can get $6,000 or $7,000 out of this car. Good job, Mater. Mike, you help him get it off, throw it in your side, and jack with it. So some people are into rockabilly, Sailor Jerry tats, and 50s cars, especially the cars.
All right, it's all yours.
Which is exactly why Bass and I are heading up to Oklahoma to look at a 55 Cadillac for a potential new build.
Push.
Ah, pass it.
Holy shit.
Now what do we do?
So I've heard that there's a Bonnie and Clyde shootout site close by where we're going.
This isn't a sightseeing tour, man. We're going to buy cars.
If we're gonna stop, let's stop somewhere cool. Bonnie and Clyde, that's cool.
It is cool. It's cars and guns and
yeah,
running from the law. That's about as cool as it gets, I guess. Yeah. So Tony Taylor finds me a couple of 1955 Coupe DeVilles up in Oklahoma, and I figured, well, the price seems about right, so why don't we go take a look at them? It's a good thing Oklahoma sucks or Texas would fall in the ocean.
That joke never gets old.
It never gets old. When I grabbed O'Brien here, because, well, he hadn't gone on a good road trip with me since the 34 Ford. We've been talking about doing another throwback build, and considering how 50s hot rods are trending, a 55 Caddy could be a real cash cow. The pictures that Tony showed me was a black Coupe DeVille. It looked like it might have been factory black. That would make it kind of rare and kind of cool. A lot of those cars were pink and blue and purple and what have you. If it's a factory black car, that's just a bonus.
I don't like it when they're Easter egg colors.
Oh, gosh. Out here in the country, all you do is just honk, right? And then you either get shot or people come out.
I'm gonna stay here until we see if they're shooting or not.
I thought sure as heck you could wreck that truck.
Hey, you must be Jimmie.
I'm Jimmie. My name's Jimmie, and I'm from Langley, Oklahoma. Have been for 72 years.
Came to look at your Cadillac.
Well, how much green you gonna cross my hand before you go to look at it?
Well, I'm not paying to look at it. I'm paying to buy it.
Oh, well, I'll sell it to you.
All right. He's a pretty cool old cat, because he immediately told me he was going to charge me to actually go look at the car. I'm like, dude, well, I should charge you for the gas for coming up here.
There you go.
That's a
look at that.
Black Coupe DeVille.
That is a black one.
You won't see a better looking one.
Really?
My own opinion.
I got you. The 55 Cadillac Coupe was a big car. In its day, it was the ultimate luxury and status, even the ones Cadillac offered in a bunch of dreamy colors. But for me, factory black makes it more valuable.
Ooh-wee, that's a lot of car. Well, I'm looking at my reflection so far, and man, it looks pretty dang straight. So was this car black originally, or is it?
No, it was actually baby blue and white.
Baby blue and white.
Oh.
All wishes aside, it's not a factory black car, but if it's clean, I could be down with it.
Well, it's a good looking motor. It's a 331.
Yeah. Richard and Brian, they're not real sure, just what to say about it because it looks so good.
Well, this floorboard on this side's been repaired.
Well, I got a new floorboard put in it.
It does need some repair back here. This trunk floor has actually got a couple rust holes in it.
Well, it's rusty there, and then there's a floor plan
on
this
side. So you might have to put a floor pan in this thing. You think about what that's gonna take?
It'll be a messy job. So Jimmy's telling me how it's the best 55 Coupe built in the world and how beautiful it is, and you know, and I'm like, Jimmy, you know, I know you like it and you've had it a long time, but maybe we need to check that prescription on your glasses. You mind if we take it for a ride?
Go for it. Guys, I'm gonna tell you something. If you break this damn thing, you buying it.
All right.
He's not even giving us a taillight warranty.
I don't know how much gas is in it. Maybe it won't run out before you get back.
That's why he brought me to push it.
Seems to do everything it's supposed to do. Like grandma going to church. This is pretty cool. We're doing 55.
Yeah, feels like it drives fine. Like floating on the cloud.
I don't know. I think if I could get it for 10 or under, it'd be worth it. I know, worst case scenario, we don't want to build it. I could just flip it.
I think you make money all day long on this car, 10 grand.
Car seemed to do just fine. Did everything it needed to do. You know, truth be told, it'd probably drive back to Dallas. This is a pretty sweet Caddy, but with the rust repair and all of that, it's not big build material.
Yeah, I like this old car. Why don't you buy it?
But it'd still be a good flip. Well, if I can get him low enough. How much do you want for it?
I'm asking 12.5. That's the best buy you'll ever have.
Yeah, but I got to get it home and do a few things to it to be able to advance it from there.
Well, that actually sounds like a personal problem.
How about
$7,500? He offered $7,500 for it. I was asking which one of them hubcaps did he want. No. But I tell you what, I'll make you a deal. I'll take 10 grand, but I've got another and I'm gonna give you.
Two for one special?
Maybe. Is it another coupe de ville?
Yes. So you got this one to go with it.
This one ain't as pretty as the other one.
Well, it could be made that way pretty quick.
Jimmie says he's gonna sweeten the deal. Like, you mean you want me to clean out your yard?
I tore all this out to be able to take the motor out.
Yeah, it's terrible. I mean, I don't think there's maybe but three or four good parts on this car, but hey, that's if it's two for one special, you might as well take it.
Exactly, because I think that the 2,500 he's tacking on, I can get a little more than that for the rusty one. All right, so 10 grand, I get both and all the parts.
All the parts.
All right, sir, we got a deal. Let's go get you some money, get back up near the house, and get Brian to loading cars and parts.
I thought you said you were gonna load it.
We settled out at 10,000 bucks for both cars. I think that's a smoking deal. It's definitely fair.
See, again, stuck loading
cars. You still stuck on that Bonnie and Clyde
shit?
I wanna see the Bonnie and Clyde shoot outside.
10 grand. You wanna see Bonnie and Clyde?
You look, you see how hard that's gonna be to load?
I don't know if I can get that up to you.
I don't know either. Hold on. Got it.
Oh, that was awkward. Sport. Leave me a break.
Oh my gosh!
I thought that Richard was gonna help, but he actually just crawled on top of the trailer and made me hand everything to him. That's kinda helping, but kinda not.
I guess the last few years you hadn't watched me and Aaron load cars, because it's usually just Aaron.
Yeah.
All right. Jesus. Time to load him up. Start with the parts car first because, well, I don't know what's gonna happen getting that thing out of the mud. But look at that. Property gas monkey. Let's go. Got him loaded. Time to get out of here. Get back to Dallas.
We made good time. Can we just, like, stop and see a couple sites on the way? I mean, we don't have to go back right away, do we?
I mean, where do you want to see?
Well, there's that Bonnie and Clyde thing, the munitions depot. I think there's, like, a giant Indian or something. Really, there is a lot of cool history around here. There's this bridge I saw. It's got, like, a bunch of arches. Are you getting a head start? You want me to come with you?
Oh, yeah, I'd come if I was you. We're southbound and down, brother. Next stop, Dallas.
Yeah, so as I was saying, since we still have a little time left, why don't we stop and see this Bonnie and Clyde site? Because I think it's really cool. It's like, it's where they had this shootout with a sheriff and a deputy, and the sheriff got shot like 7 times, and he still lived to tell about it. Anyway, that spot's like right up here.
Whoa, look at this monkey. Oh, I'm going in there. Kong's Corner. That's a monkey, dude. Oh, heck yeah. I'm going to get up on top of that. We're going to take a picture.
All right.
We're doing it.
If we must.
Oh, heck yeah. That is rad.
I mean, this is really...
Look at how cool that is.
This is really what you think is cool?
You wanted to go see a granite plaque, and I show you a giant cement primate.
Dude, I...
Whoa!
I'm pretty sure I've seen one of these before. This can't be the largest monkey or anything.
Get this picture.
All right.
This is like monkey on monkey instead of picture on picture.
All right, bananas. All right.
I'm gonna give him a tattoo.
They're not gonna believe me when I tell him at the shop.
Needs a little toughness on his arm.